Hello, neonate. How can I be of assistance? Of course. Gargoyles? Why are you asking about gargoyles? What can I tell you about them? Yes, I know something of gargoyles, and of this gargoyle in particular. I had hoped that he would meet his final death, but it seems my creation still lives to torment me. Yes. Many years ago, I created this gargoyle to protect the Chantry from our enemies. He was a faithful servant, and saved my life more than once. Unfortunately, he became increasingly upset about his role as my protector, and wished to be set free. I refused to do so. Finally, he stole away into the night, and I haven't seen him since. Isaac Abrams. His disrespect for the Camarilla is surpassed only by his hatred of LaCroix. If he finds out, it will be a source of great embarrassment for the clan and the Camarilla. He cannot learn that this gargoyle was my creation. Do you understand? I appreciate your discretion in this matter, Neonate. Here, take this. It is an ancient ward that may help you on your battle with the gargoyle. You need only carry it on your person to enjoy its protection. With much difficulty, I'm afraid. Gargoyles are notoriously resilient. Their hives are made of stone. Firearms will be almost useless. Blunt force is the only thing they understand. What can I tell you about them? With much difficulty, I'm afraid. What can I tell you about them? A gargoyle, put simply, is a creature that was created to protect the Tremere clan in the early years of our existence. They are very powerful, and not to be trifled with. Yes, we used our extensive knowledge of blood magics to create a race of protectors. They served that purpose well, but they have also caused many problems. It's a complicated issue. Well, many gargoyles still serve the Tremere masters, but a number of them have since rebelled and gone into hiding. They are a sentient race, but ultimately unfit for the freedom they desire. They need the guidance of their former masters. With much difficulty, I'm afraid. Gargoyles are notoriously resilient.
Going somewhere? What can I do to you, honey? Yeah? What do you want to know? Those guys? Yeah. Yeah, I heard of them. Why do you want to know? Really? You a cop? All right, listen. I'll tell you a little bit, but if anyone comes asking, you never heard it from me. They produce only the most hardcore video. I'm not even talking black market here, more like black hole market. Not the kind of product you want to get mixed up in. The kind of stuff that gets you put in jail for just talking about it, all right? Snuff Films is just the tip of the iceberg. I only seen one of their videos, and I swear I couldn't eat for a week. Real enough that every cop in 5 states has been trying to track these guys down. They are bad news, pal. You want some advice from me? Stop thinking whatever you're thinking and get your ass back to Kansas. Forget it, man. I don't even know what the hell you're talking about. Huh? What? Who are they? Seriously, get the hell out of here. Okay. Look, all I know is that a guy calls on the payphone down the street every once in a while. He'll say something like, the moon is a terrible mistress, or some creepy shit like that. And then all you have to say is, who walks the night with demons of dread? Supposedly you'll be told where to meet the guy to pick up product. I don't know for sure. I never tried it. It scared the shit out of me. Hey, wait. Look, you might as well know this. Word on the street is that they didn't even make the video. They're just distributing it. No one even knows where it comes from. I'm telling you, man. Whatever you're in, get out of it now.
The moon is a mysterious mistress. The Lucky Star Motel, room 2, don't be long.
Thank you. Sorry, no vacancies. Feel free, babe. This is a treasure trove of human banality. Working here, you meet lots of types of men. You get stories, you get characters, you know. This is the kind of place where writers go to study human behavior, man. It's invaluable. Does a writer write, or does he just, like, ink the flotsam and jetsam floating in his subconscious into a 120-page piece of film genius? But, you know, most of my subconscious is filled with old horror films, so that's what I write mostly, I guess. Me? I'm, like, looking to redefine the vampire movie, okay? Like, tons of people make vampire flicks, okay, popular characters, but me, I'm gonna be doing the real deal. Like, not only is it gonna be scary, but it's gonna be believable. Well, in my story, it's not, like, about garlic and bats, okay? It's about vampire societies and stuff. You know, like, what would vampires be really all about? I mean, how do they blend into society without being discovered?
Baby girl, you know I got what you need.
Master? Okay. Hey, honey, looking for a date? Ooh, I don't get to do women often. Especially ones as cute as you, sugar. Tell you what, how's 40 sound?
Need a ride?
We are living in the last days of the last age of mankind! Repent your wickedness!
Back off, vampire! Stay the fuck back! I did nothing to you! What the hell do you care? I don't give a damn if you understand. Why? So you can pass judgment on me? So you can decide if those murderers deserve to be gutted? You'll never know how it feels, never!
My family, my children were butchered by small-time criminals just looking to rob a house, steal a car, take whatever. No sense to any of it. No plan, no ransom. Just kill them because why? Because they were there, in the way? Not one of them paid. My whole family dead, my life gone. I'm supposed to let that happen? I tracked them down, hunted them, one by one, caught them all. The one you saw in Hollywood, he was the last of them. Revenge, justice, whatever you want to call it. All I thought about is taking these evil animals, ripping them to shreds and licking their blood from my claws. I don't know. Butchering those bastards was the first time I felt anything since my family was torn from me. I'm sure there are others out there whose crimes have gone unpunished.
At least I put it to use. How many vampires have used their abilities for a just cause? At least I did something!
I can't turn my back on the evil in this world. I won't answer to anyone, and you'll never take me alive, vampire. No one will take from me again, no one! Either we go our separate ways here, or one of us dies.
Hop in.
Thank you. on? What the fuck is going on up there? Dead everyone, slaughtered. Oh God. Shh. Don't make any noise. They'll hear us. Yeah, I mean, no. Fuck it. Yeah, I'm with DMP, you 5-0. Yeah, I know, but we didn't make that shit. I mean, one of the guys stole it, found it at the creepy house in the hills. We just copied it and put our names on it. Worse than anything we ever did. Worst thing I ever saw. Some of it, yeah, it was bad, but, you know, no one ever really mattered. Junkies, runaways, mostly doing them a favor. Please, just get me out of here. Oh, no! Ah!